you don't achieve worthwhile goals quickly or easily. They take time. They take struggle. They take relentless pursuit day in and day out. That's what it takes. But also, things don't usually fall apart quickly either. At least at first, it's a slow process. A little slip here, a little setback over there, a little wearing down of discipline and will over time. That's the thing. Success and failure are generally slow processes. Either slowly building things up or gradually tearing them down. And that's why I say you've got to pay attention. You have to watch. You have to watch every single second. Because those seconds, they turn into minutes. And minutes turn into hours, and hours turn into days, and days turn into years. And so, that second that just went by, that counted. And so did that second. And so did that one. And in those precious seconds, you were either building or you were decaying. You were either gaining ground or you were losing ground in that second. And in every second counts. So make every second count.
Well, you should be afraid of taking risks and pursuing something beautiful. But you should be more afraid of staying where you are if it's making you miserable. It's like the first thing you want to do is dispense with the idea that you get to have any permanent security outside of your ability to contend and adapt. It's the same issue with children. It's like you're paying a price by sitting there being miserable. And you might say, well, the devil I know is better than the one I don't. It's like, don't be so sure of that. The clock is ticking.
Yeah,
and if you're miserable in your job now and you change nothing, in 5 years, you'll be much more miserable and you'll be a lot older. It's a luxury to pursue what makes you happy. It's a moral obligation to pursue what you find meaningful. And that doesn't mean it's easy. You know, if you take people, and I've told you this, and you expose them voluntarily to things that they are avoiding and are afraid of, you know, that they know they need to overcome in order to meet their goals, their self-defined goals. If you can teach people to stand up in the face of the things they're afraid of, they get stronger. And you don't know what the upper limits to that are, because you might ask yourself, like, if for 10 years, if you didn't avoid doing what you knew you needed to do, by your own definitions, right, within the value structure that you've created to the degree that you've done that, what would you be like? Well, you know, there are remarkable people who come into the world from time to time, and there are people who do find out over decades-long periods what they could be like if they were who they were, if they spoke their being forward. And they get stronger and stronger and stronger. We don't know the limits to that. We do not know the limits to that.
I wish I had not waited 14 years. Somebody said, if you want to lose something, lose money. You can get that back. 8 out of 10 millionaires have been financially bankrupt. Walt Disney filed bankruptcy 7 times and had 2 nervous breakdowns. But don't lose time. There were 14 years I sat on the sideline. 14 years I said, I don't have an investor in me like Tony Robbins. 14 years that said, I don't have an MBA or a PhD and I can't compete with these guys. I have the complexion of rejection. 14 years I silenced myself.
Wow.
And so I regret that, because there are some people that maybe if they'd heard my voice, they would not have turned to drugs. If they'd heard my voice, their lives would have taken a different direction. And I can't get those 14 years back. That haunts me, and maybe I think that drives me when I speak with such energy. I'm trying to make up for that time, but I can't.